extra mint chocolate chip gum. All right, so as always, subscribe and comment. All right, so I'm gonna be reading and giving my opinion on the pet peeves that are listed on an article from HuffPost. 76 incredibly accurate pet peeves that will drive you nuts. And I'm gonna skip around. Okay. The first one. This channel. Loud chewing or people chewing with their mouths open. All right, I don't like that. That is a pet peeve of mine. Just because I like listening to gum chewing on ASMR videos. And I don't mind listening to people chewing gum. Snapping their gum or anything like that, that's fine. But if you are eating dinner and someone is just like chewing in a really sloppy, disgusting way, I definitely don't like that. And I don't like seeing chewed up food in people's mouths. So yeah, pet peeve for sure. cholesterol-free or something like that, when it's not like they did anything to it to make it that way. It's like, it just is that way. And like, it's obvious. Like, for example, if you bought a container of regular cow's milk and it said gluten-free, and some people be like, oh, this one is gluten-free. It's like, hello. Like, what? The milk doesn't have gluten in it. Like, please. You know, like you buy like a thing of gummy bears and it says fat free. It's like, oh, this one's fat free. It's like, big whoop. It never had fat in it. It's just all sugar. So you think that's good? just sit there and just keep snapping more and more pictures of themselves. That is annoying. But it's not because I think that they could ask someone else to take the picture. Like, that would actually be worse. Imagine if people would be like, can you take my picture, like, every few minutes? Like, that would be ridiculous. When people go to irrational lengths to keep their middle name a secret. At this point, I don't know anyone like that, but when I was a kid, I was like that. Not irrational lengths, but I just wouldn't tell people my middle name. Like, if they asked, I'd be like, I'm not telling. Because I thought it was awful. And then one day, I don't remember exactly what happened, like how this happened, but I was in sixth grade, and I don't know if the teacher was going around asking everyone their middle name or what, but when she came to me, I said, I don't want to say it, and she said, why? I said, I don't like it. She's like, oh, come on. And I told her the name in front of the whole class, and it was her actual name. Oops. Oopsie. People who say this is she, when someone on the phone asks for them, just say yes. Well, okay, that's not my pet peeve, because supposing someone calls up and they say, hi, can I speak to Mary? Oh, so you could just say yes. So yes, you can speak to Mary. You may speak to Mary, yes. Does that, then they could be like waiting, okay, where is she, you know? Or you can say, this is she. I don't know, like, who cares? Like, that's okay, you could say, this is she. I can't even think of what I say. Because nowadays, with everyone calling you on your cell phone, it's usually you that answers the phone. It's like not typical that someone calls on your cell phone asking for somebody else. Like, everyone has their own cell phone. That tell you they ate something really bad yesterday and should really stay home. Just say you're taking a sick day. Nobody needs to hear the details. I mean, I don't want to hear the details, but that's not the details. You have to say something. Like, you literally cannot call up to your job and say, hi, I'm taking a sick day. Like, that doesn't work. At least not in a job where they count on you. They want to hear something. They want to know why. Because if they didn't need you, then you wouldn't have the job to begin with, you know? Like, all the jobs I've worked at, if you call in, somebody else is going to be suffering because of it. You know, people are going to have to pick up the slack for you not being there. So they want to hear it. They want to know what's wrong with you. I mean, I don't think you should tell them disgusting details at all, but you certainly could say, I have a stomach virus, or I have bronchitis, or whatever you have. Because if you just say, I'm sick, they're not even going to believe you. Public displays of affection. That too much, like people are holding hands or something, that's fine, but anything beyond that, I don't want to see it. You know, like, who wants to see, like, people doing things out, like, at a restaurant or whatever? Like, you just, you know, anything minor is fine, but anything else, you know, you're gonna look at them and you're gonna say, hey, get a hotel room, you know. People just that busy that within an entire, say, day,